Hello everyone, this is a video recording of one of the CS Pathshala presentations. This presentation is the first of the topic Happy Maps. In this presentation, we would see simple steps to move from one point to another with the help of directions. We have four simple directions which will help us navigate from one point to the next. In today's class, we will make our cartoon character move from one place to other. You can observe how our cartoon character is moving in the bottom of the screen. Before we start today's class, let us take a look at the four directions that we would be using. These directions are up, right, down, and left. The up direction arrow takes our cartoon from a lower point to an upper point. In exactly the same way, the right arrow direction takes our cartoon to the right, the down arrow takes our cartoon downwards, and the left arrow takes our cartoon to the left. On the next slide, let us meet our cartoon character. This is Flurb, our cartoon character. Flurb is saying hello to you all. Say hello to Flurb. Very good. We have placed Flurb in one of these four boxes. On this slide, we have placed Flurb on the top left corner box. Now, look at this arrow. If Flurb has to move, looking at this arrow, where do you think Flurb will move? Do you think Flurb will move left or right or up or down? Think for a second. How many of you think Flurb will move to the left? How many of you think Flurb will move to the right? Do some of you think that Flurb will move up? Okay, the rest of you think that Flurb will move down. Ready with your answers? Let us check what Flurb will do. Yes, Flurb will move to the right. How many of you got that correct? Good job! Where do you think our Flurb is moving now? Left, right, up, or down? Ready with your answers? Let's check. Of course, Flurb is moving down. Now, where is Flurb moving now? Notice that position of Flurb has changed. Earlier, it was in the left top corner box. Now, it is in the left bottom corner box. Where do you think Fleur is moving now? Ready with your answers? Let's check. Yes, Fleur is moving up. Hope all of you got that correct this time. You all would be knowing what is coming on this slide. In which direction is Fleur moving now? Ready for the answer? Fleur is moving to the left. So, by now, we have made Fleur move one step at a time in different directions. Now let us try to make something a bit more complex and see if you can make Fleur move there. Now the number of boxes have increased. Our Fleur would like to eat the fruit since our Fleur is hungry. Can you make Fleur move to the fruit? How can you do it? Should the Fleur move up or down, right or left? Do you think you can make Fleur reach the fruit in one step, or will it require more steps? What do you think? Okay, let's check the answer. First, Fleur moves to the right by one step and then right again by one more step. So, Fleur has to move twice in the right direction. Let us check the answer again. So, it is one step right, another step right. Again, one step right, another step right, and the fruit is gone. Hope all of you got that correct. Now, let us check the next one. How will Fleur get to the fruit now? Okay. For Fleur to reach to the fruit, there is more than one correct answer. Let us check the first way that it can be done. Fleur moves to the right, again to the right, and then down. What is the second way for the same? You move down, to the right, and to the right again. Let us check both of them again. First way, right, right, down. Second way, you move down first. So down, right, right. In both cases, you reach to the fruit. Similarly, there'll be many such ways in which you can remake Fleur reach the fruit. Both approaches are the same in this case. Now, time for some assignments. Please take out your first assignment sheet. In the assignment sheet, there will be boxes showing the different directions, which is left, right, up and down. Cut them out very carefully as one block each. Now on the assignment sheet, paste them as explained below. How will you show the direction left? Paste it. How will you show direction right? Paste that. Similarly, continue for the others, which is up, down, right, right, left, down, left, and up, right, down. So the first four need to have one block each. The next one needs to have two blocks, while the last two need to have three blocks each. Now take out the second assignment. Flurp would like to reach the fruit in the maze. Can you help Flurp do that? You need to take out the directions and paste them such that Flurp moves to the fruit. Can you find the way in which Flurp can reach to the fruit in the quickest possible way? Which means it has to take smallest number of steps. How many such steps will it require, do you think? Finally, thank you everyone. Hope you enjoyed this lesson. For more such lessons, visit www.cspathshala.org. Thank you.